All right, let's work on an optimization problem where we're going to build a box. All right, we have a piece of cardboard measuring 8 inches by 10 inches, and we're going to form it into an open top box by cutting squares in the side, length X from each corner and folding up the sides. So I've done my best on drawing this, giving you an idea what this is supposed to look like. Drawing, you may be surprised, is not my strong suit. All right, but our goal is we're going to find a formula for the volume of the box in terms of X, and then find the value of X so that it's going to maximize our volume for this box. So as we get going on this, draw yourself a picture, wrap your head around exactly what's going on. Normally, what we're going to do is we're going to get a constraint equation and an objective function. So in our case, we want our objective function to be the volume because we want to maximize this volume under these constraints. On this one, we're not really going to write out a separate constraint equation. Instead, let's take a look at our situation. The constraints are going to be by the size of the cardboard. So labeling this, we know it's going to be 8 units all the way across one side, 8 inches, I guess. And then to go all the way across the other side length, that's going to be 10 inches. But they've told us that in each one of these corners, we're going to cut out a square. So that measures X by X in every single one of these corners. So just trying to label exactly what's going on there. But then we're gonna fold up these sides. So like where we have the dashed lines going on here, we're gonna fold up on those dashed lines to create this box wonderfully pictured over there on the right-hand side. So what we're gonna do is set up this volume function. We're gonna need, volume is calculated by figuring out length times width times height. So we want to represent each one of these using some sort of X's. So going over to our picture here, the folded up version, that's going to be X high. It's going to be, let me see, the width here, we can say going all the way across the bottom, let's say the 8 side is our width, it doesn't actually go all the way across because we took out these squares. So after we fold it up, it's only going to be, we can represent it with 8 minus, we remove 2 X's. And then the other side, let's say that's the long side, we'll call that the length. We can represent that by saying, well, it was initially 10, but remember we've taken out 2 size X boxes from there. So it's going to be represented by 10 minus 2 X's, however big X is. And eventually we are going to actually figure out what X should be in this situation. So back over to our volume function. Our volume can be the length. In my case, I said that was 10 minus 2X times the width, 8 minus 2X times the height, which is just gonna be X. From here, this does satisfy the first part where we've represented our volume with a function in terms of X. But now what we want to do is we want to find the value of X that's going to maximize our volume for this box. To do so, we're going to need to take the derivative, and then we'll set the derivative equal to 0 and solve down. But before we take the derivative, I think it's going to be a little bit easier if we take a few minutes and just multiply this out. So I'm going to leave the X at the end alone for right now and go first, outer, inner, last. We're going to distribute here. So 10 times 8 makes 80. My outer terms, 10 times negative 2x is negative 20x. The inner terms, negative 2x times 8 is minus 16x. And then the last, we have negative 2x times negative 2x makes positive 4x squared. The x times x will make the x squared. We can combine our like terms, still bringing that x on the outside along. So we can say this is 80 minus 36x's plus 4x squared. Now we could use the product rule at this point to take the derivative, but instead I'm gonna go ahead and distribute that x. That way we can get away with just using the power rule on this one. So x times 80 will be 80x minus 36x squared plus 4x to the third power. Now we're ready to take the derivative. So v prime, the derivative of our function, is going to be, just using the power rule, 80 minus 36 times 2 is going to be 72x to the first power as we reduce the exponent by 1. And then plus 4 times 3 is going to make 12 x to the second power as we reduce the exponent by 1 again. All right, now that we have taken the derivative, we want to find any critical values or critical numbers by setting the derivative equal to 0 and solving down. So 0 equals 80 minus 72x plus 12x squared. Okay, this is a quadratic equation. I'm going to rearrange it so it looks like a quadratic equation with our x squared term first. In this case, I think we have a common factor of 4 between all three of these terms. So let's remove that, and at least we'll have smaller numbers to deal with. So we have 3x squared minus 18x plus 20. And then we would want to maybe think about, can we factor any more? But I don't think we can on this one. So instead, I'm going to use the quadratic formula using a, b, and 3. B is negative 18, and c is positive 20. Just going to move over here. We're going to say x is going to be negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c all over 2a. From here, we can simplify down, like that negative of negative 18 can be positive 18, plus or minus. I'm probably just going to leave this all as is and put it in my calculator. Although, let's not be lazy. 18 squared is 324, or negative 18 times negative 18 is 324. And then we have 4 times 3 times 20. Would be minus 240 over 6. So 18 plus or minus 324 minus 240 would be the square root of 84 all over 6. And this will reduce down a little bit, but instead of reducing this down and getting a more exact answer, let's go ahead and get approximations to figure out how much we're going to be cutting out of the sides of these, the corners. So we have two solutions here. We have x equals 18 plus the square root of 84 over 6, and we have x equals 18 minus the square root of 84 over 6. Let's put these in our calculator and see what we come up with. In this case, I got 4.527 dot, dot, dot inches. And in this case, I got it to be approximately the subtraction case, 1.47 inches. So it looks like we have two solutions at this point, but we have to be a little bit careful because this is a real life situation. We had a box that was fixed dimensions. Remember, it was 8 by 10, and we were cutting out from the sides. So if we tried to plug in our 4.5 dot, 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 we'd run into a problem because remember up here, we did 8 minus 2 times 4.5 dot, dot, dot. That's going to turn out being a negative value, all right? Meaning we've cut off more than the side length that we actually have. So that wouldn't work for creating an actual box. So our only solution in this case is going to be this 1.47 dot, dot, dot inches. Now you could also be asked for, let me see, make sure we've answered all the questions. The value of x that's going to maximize this is going to be that 1.47 dot, dot, dot. To guarantee that it's a maximum, we could either use the first derivative test or the second derivative test. In our case, let's try the second derivative test. So I'm going in here where we had our first derivative. Next, let's go ahead and take the second derivative. So the second derivative, again, just using the power rule, is going to be negative 72 plus 24x. Power rule repeatedly, and the derivative of 80, a constant, is just going to be 0. All right, and we wanted to test this, whether it's going to be positive or negative, by plugging in 1.5 dot, dot, dot. I'm just going to use 1.5. So negative 72 plus 24 times 1.5. Negative 72 plus 24 times 1.5. I got this to be negative 36 approximately, okay? The important thing though is that this is negative. Because this is negative, that tells us that this function is going to be concave down at that value, or very, very close to that value. Concave down has this sort of look going to it, and that's going to imply that we have a maximum. All right, so after double checking, we can be very sure that our 1.47 or right around 1.5 is going to produce a maximum, and we've maximized the volume for this. All right, hope this helps out. I know box problems are a little bit challenging until you work a few of them. So keep up the good work, practice it up, you can get this.